Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.5 Developer Beta 4, and probably Public Beta 3 by the time you're watching this, or later today, or the following day, depending on when you're watching it. So iOS 13.5 Developer Beta 4 and iOS 13.5 Public Beta 3 are the same thing for those who aren't familiar. Now, this particular update came in at 169.5 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, and it was similarly sized, about 150 megabytes on my iPhone XR, my iPad Air 2, and the iPhone 6S Plus. Now let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 17F5065A, and that A denotes that we're getting very close to a final release. So whether or not the final release will be next week is hard to say, but we do know one thing before we talk about what's new with this particular update, that Apple did announce when WWDC, or the Worldwide Developer Conference, will be showing off iOS 14, and that will be on June 22nd. So if you're a developer, expect beta 1 of iOS 14 on June 22nd. You'll be able to download and install it, but usually you do not want one of those on your normal device since they're pretty buggy. Now, along with today's beta update, Apple also released watchOS 6.2.5 beta 4, tvOS 13.4.5 beta 4, and also iPadOS 13.5 beta 4, of course. They also released an AirPods Pro update yesterday to build number 2D15. So if you have AirPods Pro, you should be able to update them. Now, this particular update does not have a modem update. So if you were having issues on beta 3 with modem issues as far as your Wi-Fi or LTE connectivity, there's no updates for either of those things. And you'll still have those issues, unfortunately. However, I haven't had any LTE or modem issues with this particular update. Now, as far as notes and things like that, well, there's one known issue for some developers with coding, so that's not really anything that would affect you unless you're a developer and you're coding something specifically. And then there's a couple things that this particular update fixes, and there's a couple new features as well. So the first thing is it fixes that boot loop bug where your phone is rebooting. A couple people that are running the beta seem to have that issue. I didn't have that issue on any of these devices, but some people had it where it would reboot over and over and they had to restore the device. Thankfully, I didn't run into that myself. This should fix that. Now, one thing I'm unsure if Apple fixed in this particular beta is issues with mail, and that's why I've been using other email clients. So on my iPhone XR, I do have the same amount of notifications, and if I go into them now, they're all there on my iPhone XR. So if I go into them, you'll see there's a bunch of different email there, and it's showing me that I have them. So now I just need to make sure that it's working properly, and I can go back to Apple Mail. So I've been using others just to try and remedy this issue that I've been having, but hopefully they've fixed this bug in this particular beta. It also was confirmed that this fixes that messaging bug. So if you had those weird characters that you could place in your messages and it would lock up your device and fully freeze it, well, Craig Federighi confirmed that in an email to one of the followers of this channel, and he said that it was fixed for sure. Now, we thought that in beta 3, but at least he confirmed it. So thanks to Cameron for letting me know about that. Now, the other thing as well is that Apple has updated contact tracing and its notifications. So where this was an option that was turned on by default before, it's no longer turned on by default. So if you go down to your settings and go to privacy in this beta, and then you go to health, under health, you have exposure logging. And if you tap on it, you can't turn this on unless you have an app installed that would actually use it. So it's turned off by default and there's nothing you can do as far as that goes. So if you have an app that uses this, then you can install it or use it. Otherwise, it's just not even available. Now, previously, it was a little bit different. So I took a screenshot of it before I updated, and you'll see that it was turned on by default, and you had a couple options. So it's a little bit different this time around, which is nice. I think it's good to be turned off by default, and then you can turn it on if you want to use it when you have an app that wants to request access to it. Now, there's another update as well to your medical ID, and this is a pretty interesting update that I think will be helpful to some people. So whereas before your iPhone or your watch could notify someone if you had an emergency, it can now share more information with them. Now, under settings, if we scroll down to health, we go into health and we see health profile and medical ID. Well, if you've never gone into this before and set this up, it will actually prompt you with three different prompts to go over those settings. Now, I have it set up, so it's a little bit different. So if I go into my medical ID, I have this set up, and down at the bottom, you can see it says share during emergency call. So what it can do is actually share this information, my emergency contacts, my blood type, different things about me, if I want it to, when it makes an emergency call. So maybe I place an emergency call with my phone or my watch. You can set it up to allow this. Now you can turn this off, and it is off by default. I turned it on, but it is something that's really nice. If someone needs to know more information about you, maybe you're unable to communicate that, you'll be able to have at least the people you're talking to on the other end know this information. Now, as far as any other new features, there is no other new features. That includes the iPad Pro. However, on the iPad, contact tracing is sort of searchable. I turned it off by accident there. Let me unlock it there. It is sort of searchable, but it's not actually there. So if we type in, you'll see we have exposure notifications. And no, I will not say that word on YouTube. So we have the option here, but you can't do anything with it. So it's actually in the iPad. It was there with beta 3, but you can't do anything with it. Now, battery life on a beta is something that takes a few days to measure with any new update. You can't measure when it goes from 100% and down. You actually have to let the full battery drain and go back up, or just use your daily usage and base it off that. You can't tell right away. So if you go into settings and then we go to battery, on the previous beta, I'll show you what it was, but my battery health is now at 98% at about 7 months of usage and charging it every night. 80% after 2 years is normal, and installing an update does not cause this to go down. It simply just rechecks what the actual physical battery health of the battery inside the back of this is doing. So it's not caused by the update, it's just rechecking it, but I'm down to 98% on this device. Now, if we take a look at the last 10 days, you'll see that my battery was not great. I had 2 hours and 57 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 49 minutes of screen off time. That's playing music or doing things like that in the background with the screen off. And so you'll see I had about 50% usage, almost 40-50% usage, sometimes more, and I was getting 6 to 8 hours of screen on time. Normally you should be getting 10 to 12 with this device. Now it is a beta, so I don't expect it to have great battery life. Sometimes betas are much better than others, and sometimes they're not. But when the final version comes out, I would expect it to be the same or better. Now, overall performance, I did check performance on the oldest device here, the iPhone 6s Plus, and only the Plus devices can rotate the landscape, home screen to landscape. So you can't do this on any other device, such as the 10 or any of the newer ones. So if we go into Minecraft, I did have it open. You'll see how fast it resumes here. It takes a second and we're back in, and then we can resume our game. So you'll see that it performs well. I don't see any frame rate drops. I played around with this a little bit earlier and didn't see any frame rate drops, and things like music seem to be nice and fast to load. I really haven't had any issues just in playing around with this for the past hour or so on and off. So in general, it seems like it's doing okay. But again, it takes a few days to know that. I did have issues with settings locking up and things like that on previous versions, and they shouldn't be locking up now. And so I haven't had any issues with scrolling or anything like that. Now, as far as benchmarks, let's take a look at some of those. I used Geekbench 5 to take a look at that. And with this update, I scored 1,330 for single core and 3,454 for multi-core. So that's pretty good overall. Let's take a look at the history. If we take a look compared to the previous time I ran this on April 29th, you'll see that the single core is a little bit lower, but the multi-core is a little bit higher. So in general, it's performing good. I would expect it to perform the same or better. Hopefully we won't see any lockups, but let's take a look at all of these devices together so you can compare your Geekbench scores with these. Now, from the left to the right, we have the iPad Air 2, followed by the iPhone 6s Plus, then the iPhone 10R, and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And this should give you a general idea of how your device should be performing against these devices. So if you have similar devices, you have the oldest supported device to the newest, including the iPad, as long as you're performing in these general numbers, you should be good to go. Now, iOS 13.5 beta 4 seems like it's close to the final version based off the build number. It seems pretty complete, but Apple still could make some changes before they release it to the public. But given that it's ending in an A, and some other information that's come out has said that we should basically expect this around mid-May for the public release. So maybe we'll see the public release next week or the following week. Now, as far as iOS 14, like I said, expect that on June 22nd. So we're not too far away, a little over a month and a half or so, but we'll see iOS 14 for the first time on June 22nd. And of course, I'll keep you updated with all that information as well. well. And so there's really nothing else to talk about in this particular update that I've found anyway, but if you've found anything else in iOS 13.5 Beta 4, let me know in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.